And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Blind. I'm the RPG chick, and what are we doing out here? Well, I've got this stuff installed. Now, if you click on these, it doesn't go to the DLC, it just starts playing credits for some reason. I went to considerable effort to get these installed. For whatever reason, the Steam version does not have it included as part of the game. Now, the Origin version does. I was able to find a direct link that someone posted on a Steam forum for Bring Down the Sky, so, and that successfully, you know, added itself to the Steam version, which, you know, is kind of tricky to happen, but I guess it detected it, and that worked. As far as Pinnacle Station, there is a guide on Steam for how to do it. You have to download, well, you have to register your key from Steam in the Origin client, and then download the Origin, you know, the entire game, Mass Effect, and download that, and then take out the directory for Pinnacle Station, and change a few other things and add it to the Steam version. Those directories. So I'm gonna put links to those if anyone's watching this and they, you know, are playing the Steam version and they want to know how to get the DLCs working. Again, still, I'm playing blind, so who knows if this will even work. So hopefully it does, you know. Knocking on wood right here. There's several different pieces of wood. Now, Bring Down the Sky. Batarian extremists have hijacked a mobile asteroid station. From the galaxy map, travel to the Exodus cluster. Now, this is very easy to see on the map, too, by the way. Land on the asteroid X-57 to stop it before it crashes into Terra Nova, huh? Pinnacle Station, visit the military training center at Pinnacle Station, engage in a series of combat simulations. Argus Row cluster, enter the Phoenix system and board Pinnacle Station. Now, saying is an in-game, you know, happening that Commander Shepard has been alerted of these two things. We're gonna go here first to stop the asteroid from crashing into Terra Nova. I'm assuming she has knowledge of this in-game as well as meta, so. Zooming out again and again. Now here's the asteroid X-57 where the Bring Down the Sky DLC takes place. Here's Pinnacle Station, very easy to see. So a few of you said that I should do these before I go to Vermeer, so I am going to do so. We're gonna head to asteroid X-57. Now they said Asgard. Well, it's in here too, you can see. So excited! Boom. Alright. Now, I'm not sure if this is a completely new system. Let's take a look at Terra Nova. Terra Nova was one of the Class 1 colonization. You know what? I have it written down, don't I? Asgard. Yeah, all that was here was Utopia. So this was added. This whole system was added by the DLC. Just want to make sure. Okay, let's finish looking at Terra Nova. Terra Nova was one of the Class 1 colonization prospects discovered by the first wave of Alliance surveys in 2150. It was the second human extrasolar colony and the first beyond the Charon mass relay. It currently has the highest population of any Alliance colony. Though banded by a harsh equatorial desert, areas closer to the poles are temperate. The pace of development was modest until extensive deposits of platinum were discovered in the 2170s. This rare metal, required in the clean, burning hydrogen fuel cells that power private vehicles, attracted a platinum rush of immigrants and investment from throughout Alliance space. In the past 12 years, Terra Nova has seen a 30% rise in population, and growth does not appear to be slowing. Colony founded in 2152, population 4.4 million. Wow. The capital is named Scott. Okay, years are a little longer, as are days. Pressure's a little lower, as is gravity. Just a bit. We can't land there. We're gonna go there. But let me check out the other planets first. Loki! Cool! Loki is a small terrestrial world with little to recommend it. One hemisphere is largely covered by an ice cap and the other by craggy basaltic highlands. The rough, varied terrain suggests an ancient cataclysm caused significant damage to the world. This is seemingly reinforced by its unusually elliptical orbit, which reaches 6.5 AU at perigee and 7.1 AU at apogee. Penetrating scans of Loki's ice cap reveal a network of crisscrossing subterranean tunnels. Because some of the tunnels were surprisingly regular in shape and size, early expeditions looked for evidence of excavation. It was concluded they formed by natural processes. Loki's thin atmosphere is mainly composed of krypton and xenon. When it approaches perigee, fusion sulfur trioxides and dioxides can evaporate into clouds on the hemisphere facing Asgard. Okay. Tyr. These are all Norse gods. Tyr is a god of war, I believe. Tyr is compositionally quite similar to Earth. However, it lies over 4 AU from Asgard and possesses an atmosphere primarily composed of nitrogen and ethane. While a potential target for terraforming, the presence of the shirt sleeves habitable Terra Nova in the same system relegated Tyr to a support role. Nearly 100 corporations, human and alien, have constructed extensive teleoperated mining, refining, and manufacturing facilities across the face of Tyr. Combined with the platinum loads of Terra Nova, the resources they produce are driving development of the local hydrogen fuel cell industries. The Asgard system now supplies nearly 4% of the galactic market. Colony was founded in 2156, population 47,000. Capital is Caladidalur. It's freaking cold there. Bor. I don't know that name. Bor is a huge hydrogen helium gas giant with over 90 moons. Its striking coloration is caused by the light of ionized hydrogen filtering through an upper cloud deck of sodium. The source of the ionization has not yet been confirmed, but Bor's mass, equal to 6 Jupiters, and high temperatures suggest it may be a small brown dwarf, a large gas giant that gained nearly enough mass to ignite into a small star. Though Bor's deep gravity well makes mining operations difficult, it is the only gas giant in the system. The hydrogen needed for the local fuel cell industry, combined with the ever-present need for helium-3 fusion torch fuel, makes it economical to mine. Okay, so there's nothing to scan on any of these planets. Asteroid X-57. X-57 is a metallic asteroid originally located at the trailing Lagrange point of the gas giant Bor. With the increased development on Terra Nova, a new orbital port facility was necessary. Due to a shortage of funding, it was decided to mine out X-57, using the recovered resources to finish out the interior for habitation. The asteroid was decelerated from Bohr's orbit using fusion torches, allowing it to fall into the orbit of Terra Nova. Recently, communications with the engineering team on X-57 have been lost. The fusion torches have reignited, and the asteroid is accelerated towards Terra Nova. Well, we can't let that happen, can we? Let's land. Yeah, that sound. Oh my.
Status. Sensors reveal 3 fusion torches propelling asteroid X-57. At its current rate of acceleration, the asteroid will collide with Terra Nova in approximately 4 hours.
Well, they're propelling it. They're propelling
Hello.
It purposely.
I heard your transmission. Can you hear me?
Toward the planet.
You haven't found me yet, but I can't talk long. Shut down the fusion torches. I'm going to die. God, I hope you're hearing this.
I'm hearing it. Shut down the fusion torches. Journal. Hey, hey, bring down the sky. Find the 3 fusion torches and disable them. Let me guess, this one right there. Torch, torch, torch. Transmission tower, us. Okay, so I'm gonna head to these two first, and it looks like that's on an elevation. Have to find our way around this crap. Are these being guarded by anything? I'm glad everything's working so far. That is spooky sounds. Are all those red things baddies? Just taking a look at the horizon here. Nice.
I'm headed in the right direction. I don't know who you are, but I'm damn it.
Oh. Ouch. Oh, there's more. Oh, I see you up there. Maybe I should, like, move out of the way of there. That would be good. Yeah, there's more around, but I guess they're out of range. Shut it down by going in here? Huh. I guess the controls are in here, yeah. Can't open these. Oh my! Ooh, you are weird looking.
Terrians.
Rock! Check! Check!
Oh my. Still moving around over there. Is that it? Oh, nope. There's another one. Where are you?
Perimeter clear.
Yeah, it wasn't showing up for me. It's dark in here. No use of things being so dark. New theme and everything. Grenade storage box. Plus two grenades. Oh, that's different. Oh crap, never mind. I think these are old. Two pistols and a shotgun. Yeah. Yeah, no one can make use of these. Or that. Well, there's nothing? Well, same basic layout. That goes to the upper level. It's so dark, I don't know if I'm missing anything, but I don't want to walk around here too long. Down here. Nope. Was she wearing that on? I don't remember that color. It could just be me. Torch control. Able. Oh my god, so easy.
I'm reading that the torch is offline. Was that you? Can you hear me?
Yes.
I hear you. What's going on? Who are you?
My name's Kate Bowman. I'm an engineer. I was part of the team assigned to bring this asteroid to Terra Nova.
We were attacked yesterday by Batarian extremists. Mm. I've been hiding since they arrived. I think they know the torch went out.
Hmm. What do they want, other than to smash an asteroid into the planet?
Why are they doing this?
I don't know, but if this asteroid isn't slowed, millions of people on Terra Nova are going to die.
If I find out anything, I'll...
I've gotta go. Good luck.
Hmm. Alright. My. Oh crap. Nope. Foul. Pistol, assault rifle, light armor. Oh hey. Wait, no. Never mind. I was in the wrong slot. Striker 7. Nope. it then. Nothing else? Okay. So, it's one out of two torches. And they know that the torch went out, so we could expect resistance outside, I suppose. Or right there.
Hey.
Oh!
Oh god. I didn't mean to. Are you hurt?
What were you thinking?
You can't go firing your weapon at everything that moves. What the hell's wrong with you?
Sorry. I thought you were one of them.
Forget about it.
Leave the fighting to me from now on. Commander Shepard, Systems Alliance.
That's right.
Simon Atwell. I'm the chief engineer on this rock. Listen, we don't have much time. The Batarians fired up the fusion torches. You've got to shut them down before we hit Terra Nova. There are 4 million people down there, Shepard. My family. They live in Aronis. My kids and grandkids. Nice communities, good schools.
How bad is this gonna be? Millions dying, that's pretty bad. I understand the situation.
Batarians everywhere, and I need to shut down all 3 torches. Anything else I should know?
One of the torches is surrounded by live blasting caps. We were set up to excavate when we arrived at Terra Nova. I rigged them with proximity detectors. That tank of yours will set them off, so you'll have to go in on foot. Even then, they'll explode if you get too close. Just go slow and easy. You should be fine.
Which one has the mines? Can you shut them off?
You set them up. Can you disable them?
Not from here. No. There are manual controls by the entrance to the torch facility inside the blast zone. You can disarm the caps there. One last thing. I had a crew working off-site when the attack hit. I'm worried about them. These Batarians are ruthless. I saw them smash the faceplates of guys working vacuum. And those Varan. I don't think they always wait for a corpse before feeding.
Where would your crew be?
Any idea where I can find them?
They were running checks on our perimeter equipment. Easiest thing would be to tap into the transmission tower out on the surface. The equipment stations will show up on your sensors.
I'll do what I can.
I'll look for them, but the torches have to be my priority.
Yeah, you're right. Saving Terra Nova is more important than my team. There were a bunch of engineers over at the main facility, but they're probably all dead. That or being held hostage by the Batarians.
One of them got away.
A woman named Kate Bowman contacted me. The Batarians haven't found her yet.
Katie's alive. She's one of my best engineers. She signed on with her brother, Aaron, I think his name is. He's part of the security detail. I hope they're okay.
Let's ask him more about Kate.
What can you tell me about Kate?
Smart as a whip and bold as they come. I hope she keeps hidden. If they find her... Oh, Katie, don't do anything stupid.
Now I'm sorry, guys. This is really dark. I'll check my gamma, but I don't know if it's supposed to look like this or some setting changed. About the asteroid itself, I guess?
Why were you moving this thing in the first place?
Well, the idea was to drag it into Terra Nova's orbit, mine it out, and in the end you'd have a basic structure for an orbital station. It's a lot cheaper than getting everything up into orbit from the planet's surface. The minerals we extract almost cover the costs.
What about evacuating Terra Nova?
Give me a worst-case scenario. We can't stop the asteroid. Could the colony be evacuated?
Bet not.
Shepard, it took 30 years for the population to grow that large. I'm sure they're moving people to remote areas, but they'd never be able to get more than a few thousand off-world. We just don't have enough ships. No one does. Well, maybe the Quarians, but I don't see them suddenly showing up and offering us a ride.
Alright, stay out of sight.
You better find a good place to hide. If the Batarians come back and find you...
Yeah. I think I'll make myself scarce. Good luck, Shepard.
Three missing engineers. They must be found. The blasting caps are equipped with proximity detectors. Okay. There's two more stations, though. We don't know which one has the blasting caps. Tally, what the hell? Teleporting Tally. Is it this one? Well, this one. And there's a transmission tower.